how many of you really made it? Can I get some people that will give God some praise? Look over at somebody and tell them, I made it. Tell them, you don't know what I made it through, but tell them, I made it. I made it through the storm. Is there anybody here that'll tell somebody, I made it? Now give him a praise, somebody. Let the redeemed say so. Let the redeemed say so. You may not have ever known me or met me before, but let me tell you that I thank God for the presence of God, because the presence of God will bring us into the spirit of oneness. It's not about my denomination nor yours, but I dare you to give our God some praise. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. He redeemed you from the hand of the enemy. Tell somebody, I got a way. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your goodness, your loving kindness, for your tender mercies. We thank you because, God, you met us here. And I'm so appreciative. You brought us down the dangerous highways. You kept our minds. You kept us safe from harm, from danger, seen and unseen. So, Lord, now we just want to thank you. Now, God, you take these lips of clay and you use me for thy own glory. For, God, I want you to hide me beneath the cross and show me the way that you would have me to go. And Lord, if you'll do this for us, God, I thank you for just pouring out your spirit. Because I believe that in this place, great things shall happen. Thank you for this great man of God that lead this sheep and these persons that are in this place. Thank you for his dear wife. Thank you for the power of God to rest upon them and bless them like never before. Cause the vision to increase and flourish. Even in this next season, I thank you for what you're doing now. As a matter of fact, Lord, I thank you because you're opening up new doors for them. And Lord, we're not jealous, we're not haters. We just gonna thank you for what you're about to do. Now, God, let the redeemed give you glory, give you honor and praise. And let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart, let it be acceptable in thy sight. Oh, Lord, you have always been my strength and my redeemer. Everybody in this place that have two hands and don't mind offering them unto the Lord, clap your hands and give our God a praise. Hallelujah. Take your seat in this presence. I'm honored to be in a place, in this place at this time. I come to this church, I believe, with Prophetess Sharon Simpson, but now I'm here under the leadership of your pastor, allowing me to come at this moment and time. Can you help celebrate your leader, your pastor, your bishop, your apostle? Come on. Matter of fact, he's mine too. Come on, let's celebrate our bishop, our apostle. Give God some praise. Don't you stop clapping because his wife is sitting right next to him. Celebrate this wonderful woman of God. I love praising first ladies because I like to get wild in church. And I love it. Listen, I just want to go to the Word of God, but before I do, I want to thank the young lady that my husband of 38 years, he trusts me with this woman of God, and she drives me safely, and she protects me, and I thank her, Shante Green. And let me give you a little bit about myself. Let me get a little bit comfortable. Stay right there. I'm going to come there in just a minute. I've been married 38 years to Superintendent Richard L. Thomas Sr. And we've been pastoring for 27 years. Some ups, some downs, some feel like quitting. Tired of people. Sick of your problems because I can't get rid of mine. In a timely manner. But I'm grateful of the Lord because he's been good to me. I have 4 children, 3 daughters and 1 son. All of my daughters are married. My son, he's not. If you got some power, get him saved and you can have him. He's 32, 33 years old, and I'm 57. And I have 6 grandchildren, so I've given you my life. And I've spent it sharing it with others. I'm not going to keep you long because this is Mother's Day. Please look at a mother and just tell them, I'm so happy you made it through it all. Happy Mother's Day. Yes, God's been good. I want to go to a familiar passage of scripture, but I just want to read only a couple of verses with this, and then you can go over later in the message to Exodus, the first chapter, and go to Proverbs 31 and verse 29. I want to do this. All I have needed, thou hand has provided. Great is thy faithfulness. O Lord, unto me. Great is thy faithfulness. I'm just going back over some years in my mind. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I've seen. Just open my mouth wide and let it go, but okay. Great is your faithfulness. That's what I was looking for, a witness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies to me. Everything I've ever needed, he provided. says, my friend, great is his faithfulness. Ooh. I come to let you know it wasn't your job, it wasn't your race, but it was his faithfulness. And I dare you to come to God's house and not appreciate his faithfulness. Yeah, yeah, yeah. For 30 seconds, think about how faithful he's been to you. No music. Open your mouth and give God a praise for his faithfulness. Faithful. Shout faithful and take your seat if you can. Come on. Going to take you through all of the, oh my God, I feel something going to happen in here. I don't want to go through the whole Proverbs 31 woman at this time, but I do want to lift up something that can be encouragement to the mothers that are here. And this is to all mothers. I'm even talking about people who have no natural children, but you have a lot of spiritual children. Yeah. Happy Mother's Day to you too. Verse 29 in Proverbs 31, it says, many daughters have done virtuously. If you would just underline virtuously, virtuously, but thou excellest them all. Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. In verse 31, it just simply, it pronounces what need to come your way, and that is to give her of the fruit of her hands. Yeah. And let her own works praise her in the gates. If I had a topic or some type of something that you can take home with you, I want to just deal with this. I kind of stemmed it from the movie, and it just waking me out of my sleep, and the Lord started dealing with me. But I want to talk about hidden mother figures. Hidden mother figures. And if we could just look at the movie just for a moment, just kind of think about it. Hidden figures. The actual movie says that it's a true story of three women who all began their journey working at NASA as a part of the West Computers, a segregated group of black women hired to process aeronautic data in the space race era. They were hidden experts whose calculations helped fuel some of America's greatest achievements in history. They were considered to be human computers whose work was at the heart of the country's greatest battle. Keep up with me. The greatest battle. Our country stood at the second edge of the Second World War. The push of advancement grew greater, and a quick demand for mathematics and mathematicians were necessary. These three women were the solution this stunning achievement that's restored the nation's confidence, turned around the space race, and galvanized, meaning they stimulated or aroused others to the awareness of the world's success in race. I want to just deal with this because there's a few words that I want to pick out of their description that I want to encourage mothers with today. And that is to stimulate your thought into your belief as to who you really are in this season. I want you to understand that we don't have to lay down and let life take charge of us. As a believer, you need to let the enemy know that I am a powerful weapon against the enemy. But we're finding out that in this season, we are giving birth to some things, but it's not necessarily pleasing to our Father. And the reason it's not pleasing to our Father is because we're trying to use our weapons of knowledge and wisdom to make ourselves known. We're trying to make a name for ourselves. We're trying to make things the way that we want it. But in this process, these women, their names were never known until after the thing was over. And I need to let us know that in this season, we got to find a way to make God be first again. We have to make sure that we start to preach Jesus and not ourselves. We need to preach Jesus and not our titles, because titles have messed up many people. There's a lot of people who want to be named or called by their title, but they don't want to be called by their true name. I don't know about you, but it took me a long time to adapt and to adopt to my real name. I told other people my name was this. Whatever was popular when I was a child, I didn't know how to embrace the name Lillian. Why? Because during my era, there was names like Rita and Teresa, and those names were more open and everybody was receptive to them. Brenda and Chastity, you know, these names were coming up. So I didn't know how to accept Lillian. Until I got older to find out that it was a lily. It was a lily. It's a lily. And I found out that as I got saved, that I found out that Jesus himself was considered to be the lily of the valley. So y'all come with me. I don't know what your name is, but because Jesus is the reason for your life being what it is, I believe that it's time for a people to start really making Jesus' name known. I'm concerned about us in this season because we don't talk about Jesus until he blesses us with new houses and cars. I'm concerned that we only talk about him when he give us what we want. That's spoiled children. I want to talk to some people that know how to bless him and call his name even when you are at the lowest of your valley. Is there anybody in here that know that there's power in the name of Jesus? Tell somebody that's that name. That's the name. That's really the name. Because his name should be the name that stimulates our praise. It should not be that we have to tell you to come on, praise him, when you know that he's been real good to you. Tell somebody, I just need an opportunity to give him glory. I think I'm in the right house that recognize that at the name of Jesus, it prompts your praise. Why? Because that's the name that took you out of darkness. That's the name that made you. He gave you beauty for your ashes. Some of you, you didn't know how what it felt like to smile. Before now, when you were in the world, all you did was cried and you partied so you wouldn't have to cry. But tell them, I got a new party going on now. My praise is to the Lamb of God, because I know what I was, I know where I was, I know that I didn't have peace in my mind, but it was the name of Jesus. And so I just think that at this moment, it take a people to recognize that hidden name. That hidden name, it's the name that many have concealed and hidden for a moment. But I come to ask the church today. I can only ask you, because you know, you can't make nobody be saved. But I just want to beseech you to talk about this name, because it is his name that's going to take us through the real storms. Y'all, the pandemic really wasn't a real storm. The pandemic just drove you home. But the real storm is the after effects. It is the earthquakes that happen, and then it's the after shocks. Come on, y'all, hear me in here. And every now and then, you have to remind yourself, God brought me out of COVID. Yeah, but God also reminds us, because some of us are still carrying, as the woman of God said, some effects from that experience. Oh, I don't think it's a bad thing, because anything that can keep God fresh on my mind. Anything, matter of fact, as a little thing such as breath, if he just want to use my breath to teach me that it's him that give me life. Oh, tell somebody, I thank God for life. Oh, yes, I do. Yes, I do. I thank him. I thank him. Because so many people are sleeping. And they're going on with the Lord, and it's not COVID that killed them. It's the after effect. And I want you to understand that God is looking for some mothers, even in this season. I know the enemy has done a lot of things to these wonderful, beautiful faces that you've seen, that you see in here. Look at somebody and tell them, I done been through something. Now, you ain't gonna say that if you have never been through something that really touched your heart. But some of us have really gone through something. You looking at me, but I understand the role of a crack addict. My husband did it for 37 years, and I had to pray him through. I had to pray him through even when I didn't know how to pray. Y'all not hearing me in here. I had to pray for him when I really wanted to leave him. I still prayed him through. Y'all not hearing me. Can I find five transparent people? You didn't like your circumstance, yeah, but you prayed your way. Somebody shout through. Yeah, I prayed him through. I prayed him through, Apostle. I prayed him through. I prayed him through. And when he came through, I also asked God. I said, now, Lord, now hold on. I'm praying him through, but also give him some peace of mind. Because I'm still going to leave him if he don't have no peace. It's my testimony. If he don't want to stay with me just to stay, leave him with me with some peace. See, y'all chasing money, you got to be chasing peace. You chasing a man with some money, you better chase the man with some peace. Oh, I wish we could snap on that real good. Tell somebody, yeah, he got to have some peace. Because every now and then, I don't have that peace to supply for both of us. Every now and then, I snap. I have an emotional, breakdown. But I need a man that can hold me and keep me while I'm in the midst of my storm. Yeah, he needs some money, but hey, the money ain't gonna keep y'all always. Matter of fact, he'll trick you and take it all out the bank and leave you and go to You be looking for your money and he over there under another alias. But if he got peace in his mind, can I talk to the women in here? And then God's looking for mothers that will understand, don't put all your life into children that don't want what you want. I hear you. How can you say that? Because if we spent less time worrying about our children, then we would spend less time at the doctor's office. I come to tell you, some of your sickness is because you didn't know how to put them on the altar. See, because love is not rejecting them or turning away from them. It's just standing firm on what you believe. And let me tell you something about our children. As long as they are in the hands of the enemy, they are manipulators. They some little devils. They'll rob you of your money and still kiss you on your cheek. I snapped a couple of days on one of mine. I say, hey, my Cash App don't work. Now, I didn't lie to him. Let me tell you what happened. I hit that button so that nothing can be transpired. That privacy security button. So when it was time for me to work it, it didn't work. It'll send you a message, it declined. So the same message go to the one that's trying to get money from you, that it declined. Oh, y'all need a lesson real quick before I hoop to you? Go inside of your Cash App. There is a place called security. Hit that security button, close it down, lock it up. Because when you lock it up, nobody can take from you. Because kids will take your money, spend it on their fame and their fortune, their fun, while you worried about where they are. I'm talking to a mother in here. But the Holy Spirit sent me today. He told me to tell you that this is your day to be free from that. I gotta move faster than this. He said that there are some hidden figures that need to understand their role in my kingdom now. What is my example of this? I don't want to get thrown out because I can really go there with y'all. But hidden figures, you know that you are hidden. Some of you are hiding the gifts and the things that God has given unto you. You're hiding those gifts, sitting back, becoming a perfect eye servant and a perfect pew member when you should be up working. Because you got skills that can take the ministry to the next level. How many of you know that God is looking for a people that will say yes in this season? And so I need to talk to the mothers because anything you're trying to birth in this season, the devil's trying to kill. How do I know this? It's found in Exodus 1. I want to talk to those midwives that understand that you need to be some people that will help somebody else come out of what they're in. Oh, yeah, I'm fixing to talk to the people that will say amen so I can get. He said, I'm looking for these people that are hidden in the back, that in the shadows, that are wondering, what is my purpose? Who am I? What I've been called to do? Let me tell you something. Don't let all of these stage wonders and confuse your mind in knowing that you have no value. Tell somebody, I've got some value. Matter of fact, I have enough value. I have enough power within me to be able to prophesy to to wait on anybody to give me a prophetic word before I believe the report of the Lord. Exodus 1, you find the midwives that are trying to give birth and bring forth. Let me tell you something. You have to bring a difference between Egypt and the children of Israel. You got to make a difference between holy and unholy. You got to make a difference, y'all. It's a difference. I'm sorry. I'm not just old school, but I'm foundational. I like to hold on to my foundation, because if they wouldn't have told me, no, y'all don't want me in here. If they would have told me that I could be what I was before now, then I promise you, I know how to play church. But tell somebody, nobody's looking for a player. We're looking for people that love God for real. God say, I'm looking for somebody that will love me even when there's an all-out assault against your life. You are ready to give God glory. Oh, tell somebody, I love God. I gotta rush on to the end. The midwives are here wondering, hey, who we gonna stand with? Pharaoh said, we have to die. We gotta kill all the firstborn male. But listen, I can't kill what I'm a birth in this season. And I won't let you kill it either. So I wanna talk to the hidden figures who are behind the scene, that you see things happening to your brothers and sisters and you mute your mouth. You go on mute, you won't help them through. Oh, and all you're concerned about is if they receive you. Do you not know that God never told us that witnessing would be easy? He never told us that it was going to be okay for you to, for when you tell me that I'm wrong, that you won't cry. Yeah, we cry sometimes. But who are you standing with? You see, in Egypt, they had to make up in their minds, either we're going to trust God, or we're going to follow Pharaoh's orders. Now, I'm going to break this real down real quick. Because we've got to show who our real daddy is. We got to show who your real king is. Ooh, I'm finna hit y'all real hard. Because I see y'all walking around, he's my king, my king, my queen. Take that shirt off. You know the king and you like a queen. You've accepted it. But he's been a killer to your purpose and your destiny. And either you're going to trust God enough to cause your spiritual life to live. God, you're hearing me. You're helping me. Cause your spiritual life to live. I found out, Apostle, I love my husband 38 years, but there are times that when God is trying to say something to me, he can't pray with me. You go to the office. Because there's some stuff I want to say in my prayer that you don't need to hear. It's not a defilement to our marriage or to who he is with me. Because I love him, but I love God more. And I believe that there are some things that God wants me to know that my husband don't have to tell me. Because for a season, I was codependent upon his orders. And I didn't know how to receive my own instructions because he was giving me his instruction. I'm not taking away because he still give me instruction. But there are times when I can feel God turning. opening my birth canal, and he's telling me, I want to give you something that you can birth on your own in this season. I want to show you that I use both male and female. I want to show you that I'm the God of all humanity. Oh, y'all not hearing me. And I wait on God to give me instruction. While I serve my earthly king, I call him Lord, all that. But at the end of the day, I have to make him known, honey. I need to hear from God. Can I find 100 women that just want to hear from God? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I got to rush through. I've been up a minute. I got to rush through because I want to hear from God. Because if I hear from him, I can serve my husband better. Let me help the real chicks out. Because some of us really don't know how to be submissive. I grew up with 3 boys, so I'm used to talking back. I talk back to my brothers. They didn't get to run me. I had a fight with 3 boys, and none of them were soft with me. They treated me like a dude. So I had to go boyish with them. And when I got married, the first time he told me something, I had an attitude. I didn't like it. And I said something. The word that we established in our home is that we'll never say, shut up. Because to me, that's cussing me. To mute me is to curse me. So I slipped and said, shut up. That struck something in the man, because a real man ain't gonna let you just go off like that. I like his little thuggish self, too. I like his little thuggish self. He said, woman, you lost your mind. I swallowed. I said, yes. So I went into prayer asking God, God, listen, show me how to be submissive, because this submissive thing is not working for me, because it makes me feel punked. Can I say that in here? It makes me feel punked. It makes me feel like I've been tricked. It makes me feel like he's walking on me. And I'm claustrophobic, so don't walk on me. And I said, Lord, you have to show me how to be submissive, because I love my husband and I don't want to leave him and I don't want him to leave me, but I will. My mama showed me what a real single mother can look like and still be saved. We didn't have men running in our house. My mama was saved. She didn't get married until we was 18. And I was ready to leave the house. But I tell you, I had to pray by submission. How many of you struggle with it now? Don't raise your hand. Your husband gonna chop your arm off. Don't you raise your hand. Let me tell you what to raise. Raise your eyebrows. Raise them lashes. Because real talk, I want to hoop this out, but I can't. The enemy said to us as women, giving birth in this season simply means that we're alone trying to do it. And I've come to talk to hidden figures, mothers that's in here that see another sister trying to get her dreams going. And you know what it takes to help her to get there, but you too jealous. You're too covetous. What will it take you to help her? And then she turned back around and help you. I'm talking to entrepreneurs in here. Because some of us at my age, we feel like life is over. Well, I just made the devil a lie. My life ain't over. I just passed my finals yesterday. Finna give me a little bachelor's degree in theology. Y'all not hearing me, baby. I'm going right back in so I can get my master's. I ain't quitting till you can call me Dr. Thomas. I put all my children through school, college. I'm not talking about no baby college. They graduate from Baylor University. You know that's some money. I still don't know how I paid it. I was broke. But they have degrees. They're married. They have children. All of their children are just doing well. Now it's my turn. Yeah? Now where are the women that's in line with me that'll say, yeah, it's my turn as well. I've got some things on my bucket list that don't have nothing to do with a vacation. Because my life is bigger than a vacation. I'm ready to make my own coins. And some of you make some pretty good coins, but you still, you know. You're supposed to own that thing. I'm a six-figure woman. Well, what about being 7 or 8 and you own it? Because I'm in a house right now, I feel it by the Holy Ghost. I'm in a house of nothing but millionaires. I don't say that. I don't say that, but I see it in the spirit. And I need the person with the true faith to believe that you're one of them. I dare you to start praise. Yeah, that's it right there. To give my God some praise right now. Because God let the pandemic come so you could get your own destiny in your own hand while he leads you everywhere God leads you. Tell him prosperity will follow. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. So the midwives dealt well, and they made a decision. Look at your neighbor and say, yeah, we're fixing to make a decision. Tell him, I see my money coming. I just praise God for my millions. So I've got to make some decisions. Can I help us real quick with one note? When God give you the plan, don't compromise the plan with Egypt. In our text, Proverbs 31, he said, favor is deceitful. Listen, let me tell you something. You have favor, and favor is good. But tell somebody the favor of the Lord comes after I've made a decision. And that decision must be that when I get ready to celebrate my millions, that I'm not on social media with the biggest glass of Hennessy. Cavassier, what's wrong with you? God and spirits don't mix. Okay, okay, they don't like that one, Lord. We dance, we shout on the promise, but we don't like the practice. There's a practice that goes with your promise. My God, I feel God. And God said, when we get our practice together, things will change. I have three things that I want you to do. I want you to make a decision to fully follow God. Secondly, I want you to connect yourself with women that know how to celebrate. Your birthright. I need you to learn how to get with some women that won't kill everything you're giving birth to. This is my last thing, and then I'm gonna try to scream a little bit at you, and then we're gonna go home. The last thing we have to do, we have to protect the birthplace. Those women in Exodus were giving birth. If you read it in the Message Bible, the Bible says that they were giving birth so quick till the women of Egypt couldn't even come in and take their baby. Oh, here's a prophetic word for you right now. God say you're getting ready to birth some things out so fast that the devil can't stop what you're about to bring forth. Can I find 100 women that'll say, yeah, it's coming, it's coming. For the last few months, you've been feeling like God's about to turn some things around in you. You could see God turning that thing around. Is there anybody in here that would say, I felt that push? But while they were giving birth, Bishop, there were three women. Two at the birth canal helping to bring forth the baby. Now this is my mind, because they knew that the Egyptians were coming. So that simply said that there was one gangster woman protecting the birthing place. I need to find some real gangster women that will go into the heavenly realm and begin to pray for your birthing, because in this season my job is to help pull you out. Look at somebody else and tell them, mama, we coming out of this strong. I know you didn't know that I had the fight I have in me. I know you didn't know that I was virtuous. Virtuous simply mean that I'm stronger than I ever been, without any tampering, without any decay. But even in the midst of it, I will fight for the sake of your destiny. I don't want to see you go back to Egypt for your help, but now is the day that we push forward. Tell somebody, push forward. I see a few people in the back. If you'll just praise God with me for a second, nudge that mama and tell her, say, mama, push forward. I know you've cried some tears in this season. I know that you've had some burdens that you didn't like, but God said, push forward. Go on and push forward, because now unto him who is able to keep you from falling, push him and tell him, push forward. Yes, because if you would protect the birthing place, what does that signify? It signifies I'm preparing for increase. The birthing place is the place where increase is pushed out, because had they not hid Moses in the bush, then there would have been a problem for the children of Israel. But I came to tell some You can't let the Egyptians rob you of your seed. You can't let your past keep you from pushing, from pressing, from reaching the mark. I dare you to tell somebody, push forward. Yes, I know you've been lied on. I know you've been under attack. But push forward, because you have a seed of God on the inside. Tell somebody, I have a baby, and his name is not natural, but his name is supernatural. And when I push forward, what I bring birth to, the devil can't stop it. Upon this rock, come on, Peter, help me. I build and the gate of hell, oh, I feel, shall not prevail. I can't let nothing kill my baby in the pandemic. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Y'all go with me. That's old school. A little Kojic up in here. Somebody say, yes, Lord. That's a sign of surrender. That simply say, I'm not in charge, but my baby's daddy is in charge. His name is Jesus. Yeah. Yeah. What I'm bringing forth in this season, I'm looking to bring forth my prosperity, my peace, my joy, my love. Y'all know I want to hate you like you hate me, but it won't let me. I want to tell you off just like you told me off, but he won't let me. My baby daddy told me to shut up and keep quiet until a season that you can push out. Tell somebody, I'm in a birthing place that's under protection. What I'm about to deliver, God put it in place. Oh, I dare you in here. All you mothers, you cried, you prayed, and the devil said your children would never come in. I dare you right now, with no music, to give your blood, give a shout, give a praise for all of your children, all of your grandchildren, all of your generation, the next generation. Y'all not hollering. Yeah! You gotta sound like you in the delivery room. No epidural. It's only natural. It's only natural to give God praise. Everybody praise him. I'm done. I'm ready to go there. I'm ready to go there. What? Pastor, can I come down right here? What I'm giving birth to, it can't die. It multiply. I'm laughing because my little childhood name was Bebe. And y'all remember that old school Bebe? We don't die. Oh yeah. And in this season, I dare you to look at somebody and tell them everything I give birth to, it's gonna increase so large. It's gonna run into your field. I got so much increase coming. You don't even have to tell me the social distance. because I've got so much increase, it's going to push you way over there. But tell somebody, wherever you are, give birth to what you have. You don't have to look at mine, and I don't have to look at yours. But I dare you in the spirit right now that will open your mouth and praise God for your birthing. All you hidden mothers, you've been hiding in the background. But you a figure to be reckoned with. I dare you to use your praise to set the bar. Let the devil know I'm not taking no for an answer. But all of the promises of God, they are yes and they are amen. I dare you to praise him for his yes and his amen. Give God praise in this house. Glorify him. I'm ready now. Is there anybody in here that know without a shadow of a doubt that this is your real season? I want you to take a little walk up and down this aisle and just claim your land. Claim your property. Claim your blessing. Claim what you believe. Claim your healing. Claim it. It's not a hoax. It's not something that we just conjured up. But it was through them, the children of Israel. They walked around the walls until the walls came tumbling down. Give God praise. Ain't no COVID. This is COVID-free zone. Give God praise. There it is. There it is. Come on, elevate your praise. Let it turn to... Hey, yes, oh, Baba. Yes, I'm restoring unto you the years. Year. That's a locust. Somebody praise him. Woman of God, right there. Ma'am, come on back. Come on, walk with me. Walk with me. Every scheme, every lie that the devil stole and taken from you, God's restoring. Hold on. Before he gives you your blessing, the heart must be healed completely. I'm not talking about bits, pieces, and parts. I'm commanding that you be healed now, because your blessing is so soon to come to your household. And we can't let our hurt get in the way of our pain. And you can't let the pain get in the way of your promise. That is. Let her rest. Let her rest. She needs the rest. She needs the rest. Lift those hands all over this place. Oh, yarabaso. Come on. And while you're lifting, worship. Come on, open your mouth and worship. Ma'am, you got something written on your dress like Vogue or something. Come here. I dare y'all to praise while you're looking. Lift those hands. Oh, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, yeah. Let me tell you what's about to be rewarded for you, your faithfulness. But I have to tell you something. Do not complain. I hear you. I don't complain. Yes, you do. Mm-hmm. I'm going to snatch it out because in this season, we're going to get that out of there. And I'm not up here to tell you it's going to get better before it get worse. Worse is a signal to the saints that better is on the way. That's why we shouldn't panic. You hear me? I take out of you all of the complaining, all of the murmuring. You faithful, but you critical. It's only because you like excellence. You like it. But God wants you to accept somebody else's excellence as well, without complaining. This ministry could use more of you. But they can't because you're complaining too much and it gets in the way of privileges. So I'm going to get that out, okay? Because after this, you can find me on Facebook. I don't do all of them now. Find me on one of them, Lillian Thomas, and tell me how God has blessed your life. Since complaining has left your spirit. You hear me? Because after this, if you stop complaining by the power of the Holy Ghost, God said, I'm going to restore you in every area of your life. Your husband here?
I'm not married.
You're not married. Good.
Not yet.
Okay. If you get rid of it, he'll come. Okay, Holy Ghost. It might even been someone who have been in your vicinity and really was attracted to you, but that complaining and the way you talk turned them off. But I'm going to pray he come back again because he was a good one. Father, I thank you for revealing your glory. For revealing your truth. I thank you because this mighty woman of God, who you have chosen to be an intercessor, to pray and to lay hands on people, I pray that you would snatch out of her humanity criticism that is damaging and not encouraging. It's only because of the experiences that she's had that caused her to be so critical. But Lord, help her to take her past and count it all as joy. Ooh, I feel it. I feel the Holy Ghost. Yes, Lord. You feel it. Yes, you do. If somebody would pray for her right now, she's getting her deliverance right now. Because this murmuring and complaining has to go, because it's like a cancer that sneaks in this ministry. And there are people that love you and they listen to you, but they don't need to hear that. This is no embarrassment to you, ma'am. I'll hug you and I'll embrace you and I'll restore you. I will never embarrass anyone, but I brought you to the light because you've been hidden. You are a hidden vessel of honor, but we snatch out of you murmuring and complaining, even in your house. When you're all alone, you're complaining, but I bind it. I cancel the assignment of the enemy that will come to distract this powerful woman of God. I don't know your real true relationship with your pastor's wife. I don't know. I'm not here. I guarantee you, if I stood here, he would show me. But I won't need to tell that. All I need you to do is find personal time to spend with her. because she can help you. She can help you. You've been avoiding this personal talk with her, trying to use it as church work, but you need some personal attention. And I pray that God will send deliverance for you so that you can reap the good of the land, so you can enjoy your new season of life. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things are new. Oh, now when I touch you this time, ma'am, I'm gonna take my hands off, and but when I touch you this time, the power of God is gonna touch you from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. Here it comes. Get your spirit ready. Get your spirit ready. Yes. That is, yes. Oh, oh. I take out of you all of the wounds of the past. Be healed. Oh, yeah. There it is. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. There it is right there. The wounds of the past. There they are. There they are. The wounds of the past. Ooh, yeah. Release. Everybody lift those hands. Yes. Now worship where you are. Worship where you are. There's a couple here. I need to pray for a couple here. And you've been serving God. You've been giving God your all. But it's like little things that come between you and the wife. It's just small irritations that could blossom into bigger things. You don't have to come to me, but I want every couple in this building to just hold hands with your wife. Harry. I have to pray. Father, I thank you for the couples in this place. I pray that there will be a divine peace that surpasses understanding to be released in these homes. And for the couple who have considered separation, and I'm not talking about a radical, volatile type of separation. I'm talking about a quiet, I see it in the Holy Ghost, like a quiet decision made. Where you could still be friends, and it's only because you don't want people to know. But I come against it. I come against the separation. I come against the separation. I come against the separation. It can be worked out. Yeah, get your deliverance, baby. Just get your deliverance. So I pray for these families, these couples, that you will send healing. Let the wives be healed and the husbands be at peace. Go to their jobs and give promotion to the men so that they can take care of their wives the way they desire. I pray that you release it into their homes. Cause prosperity to come. Lord, and then for the couple who is just phenomenal. They work like a team. Lord, I thank you for this million, multi-million dollar plan that's between the two of them. Lord, and I just pray whatever you do, keep them strong. Keep them as one. Don't let the money bring them to a place of separation. Let them grow in grace and in your knowledge. In the name of Jesus. Everybody clap your hands for them, for the couples now. Yes, Lord. Yeah, Lord. Yeah. I have one more. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I'm trying to go. Sir, can I pray for you? Sir? Yes, sir. Can I pray for you? One thing about me, y'all, you don't have to worry. I ain't going to do things that I ain't supposed to do nowhere. But lift your hands, sir. The greater glory is resting upon you. There's a greater glory resting upon you. It hovers over you, even at night in your bedroom. There's a greater glory from God that's resting upon you. I called you up here because sometimes you're a little bit harder on yourself than you should. But when I lay my hands on you, I want you to receive yourself as the gift that you really are. And even while I lay my hands upon you, I want you to go ahead and accept the call that's upon your life. You don't have to run. You don't have to avoid it. Only reason why you don't want to do it is because so many have made a fool of it. But God wouldn't make a fool of it out of you. He said, you didn't choose me, I chose you. Oh, yeah. Sir, I know I asked you to lift your hands a little bit ago, but go ahead, lift it again. Because there's a worship that God wants you to release unto him. You watch a lot, but you know what? You have a praise that need to be released. And when I count to three, I want Trinity to just go up in a praise with this young man. Because there's a holler that's going to come out of him. One, there's a holler going to come out of him. Two, yes, sir. Yes, sir. I know what I see. I know what I know. How come a holler gonna come out of him? Three. Yeah. Oh, there it is. Yes. Yeah. There it is, son. Yes, God. Been working with him. Come give him a big hug. There's an anointing you're about to transfer to him. And while you're doing it for him, God say, I'm answering some things for you. Somebody ought to praise the Lord. Somebody ought to praise the Lord. Yeah. Come on. Somebody ought to praise the Lord. Thank you for your healing virtue, Jesus. Thank you for your healing virtue, Lord. Yeah. I got you. I just want to lay my hands on you. Church, no claps, just your mouth. Worship right there. Come on. Just your mouth. Come on. For her sake, for her sake. Ooh, there it is. Yes, ma'am. Come on. There it is. Yes, Lord. That's the touch. There you go. Just breathe. There you go. Just breathe the breath of life. There it is. Just breathe, baby. Yeah, 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 yeah. Just breathe. Where's the young lady that was singing? Ma'am, can you sing that? You know that breath, breathe? Grab the words, do whatever you can do. She's so powerful. Just breathe. There you go. Come here. Yes, ma'am. I'm trying to go, Pastor. I'm not gonna take all day. Oh, oh, oh.
Hold on now. Just breathe. Hold on. Just breathe. Hold on. Just breathe.
For you, that's so amazing. Protecting the birthing place was not in my notes. It was when I stepped out of my car and those gentlemen, they said, good morning. I said, good morning. And I watched all of them make sure that everybody got in very safe. And right then, the Holy Spirit said to me, tell them to protect the birthing place. Let me tell you something. You're in a house where all of the gifts that God has put into your life, this is the season for you to give birth. But it's protected by the Holy Ghost. I have to say this because some of us recognize our gifts in God and then we go and use them for our own gain. Or we use them for popularity or for people to know us. Or we use them just so others can praise us as if we need attention. But you're in a protected place. Some of you have come from other places to this ministry and you haven't fully been able to trust. You're in a protected place. Grab that hand, tell them, say, we got to come forth in this season. Come on, grab somebody's hand, tell them we got to come forth in this season. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Ma'am, lift those hands. Lift your hands. Such a sweet mother. You've given all your life to your children. But I called you up here because I don't want you to go home with that same burden that you've been carrying. I called you up here so that I could pray that you be relieved of those burdens and that your body become completely rejuvenated, restored, and whole. You hear me? I'm not one of those that will run around pushing heads down to the floor. I just believe in laying my hand on you and letting the power do whatever it needs to do. But I remove from you worry and fear and doubt and stress. I remove from you that. And I pray that you have a good Mother's Day today. Celebrate yourself. Be at peace with who God has called you to be. No more worries, no more fear. If you would, after I take my hands off of you, I want you to give God a praise. And after you praise him, go hug your First Lady. And just receive that warm embrace. Power of the Holy Ghost. Father, I thank you for healing. Thank you for lifting this load. Thank you for the strength of God. Thank you for the power of God resting upon her. In the name of Jesus. And we'll forever give you praise. Give her strength in her body.
Thank you, Jesus.
Give her strength.
Thank you, Jesus.
Even now, give her strength. Strength. Strengthen her. In Jesus' name. There you go. Go give that hug to your First Lady. Go ahead. Go give that hug to your First Lady. Everybody say, breathe. I don't know the words. Just breathe.
Just breathe.
Now, we're getting ready to go. We're getting ready to go. Can I pray for that family right there? You can just stay over there. You don't have to come up here. Take your young lady. Oh, she's so gorgeous. Father, we thank you for this family. This complete family. This complete family. Is this all your children? You have one more? Mm-hmm. Is there one more here? Where are they? In Georgia? Yeah. So we're going to join hands and we're going to pray for the one that's in Georgia. Like you always do. But the only reason why God would show it to me is because you amongst a cloud of witnesses that's going to pray you through, because you'd be concerned about that child oftentimes. Yes, Lord. I better go ahead and tell you to come on up here where the altar is. Come on, bring your family. You do everything you can not to worry, but you are worried. You are worried. And if I've ever seen a man that want to make sure his family is well, I'm looking at one. There are some fathers that the kids go away and then they just accept that they're gone. But it's like, Lord, the world is so wicked and it's so crazy. And Lord, I need you to take care of my child. But I come in agreement with your prayer. I'm not coming with a new prayer. I just come with agreement with your prayer as a family. Because through your tears, your Father has heard you. And the scripture said that a poor man cried unto the Lord and he heard him and he delivered him from all of his destructions. So, sir, I'm going to lay hands on you and you're going to lay hands on your family. Father, I thank you for this family. I come into full agreement. With this praying man that leads his family in prayer. We come in agreement now. Give them peace. Give them strength. And Lord, let them know that their faith is working for them. in the matchless name of Jesus. And sir, as you have done in times past, we lay our hands upon you that you may gain strength. Father, I pray that you will strengthen him from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet. Let him not grow weary in his well-doing, but let him reap if he don't faint. Now, God, strengthen him so he can strengthen his family. Yes, God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I'm saying yes because he's just showing me the things that you're aware of, and sometimes you can't say anything about because you don't want to make the house nervous. But God, we thank you for this powerful man of God. Somebody please come stand behind him, because the strength of God be upon you, man of God. Oh, God heard your cry. He heard you. He heard you. Somebody give God praise. Come on, Trinity. Open up your mouth and praise God with them. Come on. Come on, saints in the house of the Most High. There it is. He anointed our head with oil. Our cup runs over. I gotta go. You standing next to someone, just embrace them real quick. We're going home. Well, that music is right there, sir. That's right there. Thank you. Embrace them. Let them know. Listen. You're a hidden figure. You're the hidden figure with those powerful treasures hidden inside of you. So let that person know, yeah, we're going to bring it forth in this season. And we coming out strong. Let them go and let's clap our hands and glorify our God. Come on, I gotta go. Oh, yeah. I never take my seat without offering Christ to someone. If you want Jesus Christ, come to me right now. Harry, Harry. Harry, because it takes you longer. My God. Come on, if you're here, come on, I'm waiting on you. I'm waiting, come on. I'm waiting. The church is waiting. Every one of you. Say this with me. I believe that Jesus died for my sins and he rose again that I might live. I thank you, Father, for bringing me back to life again. Forgive me of the sins that I committed against you, and restore me back to the fold in the name of Jesus. I speak healing, delivering over all of your lives, and I thank God that you are now saved. Everybody shout, I'm saved. Oh, yes. 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 You are just as saved as I am. Hear me, you all. Don't let him go. Do whatever it takes to fight for this salvation. it's prayer meeting, if it's back-to-back services, if it's Bible study, do it like you did the clubs. So now I got to come back up in that mug. I got to get back up in there. I got to go to church because that's where my strength is. That's where my life is. You could have lost your life, but God spared you. You could have taken a life. God spared you. Now tell him, say, Lord, thank you for saving me. Ooh, something about you. There's something about y'all. But old things are passed away. This is your life. He rose so that you might live. He died to redeem you from the hand of the enemy. So now you're here. Father, we thank you for these souls. Five souls. Father, I pray peace upon this woman of God. Give her peace that surpasses understanding. And guard her heart and her mind. Jesus. Oh, that is. Yes, Lord. Jesus. Mm. It's the power of God. That's him. Sir, you are forgiven. Sir, you are forgiven. I know you feel his presence because I feel him as I'm touching you. He told me to tell you, you are forgiven. So would you do something for me? I want you to just shout, thank you, Jesus. There you go. Say, thank you, Jesus. And do me a favor. Go over there to your pastor and embrace your pastor because he's going to transfer a powerful anointing upon your life, sir. There you go. There you go. That's an anointing. Everybody give God. Come on, midwives. Come on, midwives. Hey, hey. How you feel? Come on. How you feel? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Just breathe. Just breathe. Come on over here, Cunningham. Come here, babe. This is a powerful woman. Can preach you under the pew. But you know what? We give out so much. We just give, give out. Give out. And then when it's time for us, we give ourselves a little bit. But I come to restore all of your strength back. Oh, yes, Lord. Matter of fact, I'm coming to give you some rest at night. You're not resting as you should at night. Somebody call you at 3, you up like you, it's good morning. But I come to give you some rest. Because there's an inner thirst in you that you want from God. And you, it's like, God, I want it, but I have all these distractions. But I come to give you some rest and some peace. My, that is, yes, Lord. Ooh, it's kind of a so shabba. Ooh. Ooh, my so yabba. There's your rest. There's your rest. Yeah. Give it to him. Cast all of your care upon him. Yeah. Come on, release it out. Cunningham, everybody clap those hands and give the Lord glory. Now, can y'all just take me to church real quick? Just real quick, you can come back to this, but just take me to church real quick. Come on, organ. Yeah, that sounds good. Now for 30 seconds, can I get Trinity to just go crazy giving God some praise right now? Yeah, that sound all right. Come on, bring it on up a little higher. Yeah, hallelujah. Yeah, mama. My promise is coming. My help is here. If you could run, I just needed I need somebody else that'll just take off from this building, giving our God, come on, my God, there it is. On this altar, I need somebody to keep up with them until they understand and recognize the power of the Holy Ghost. Some crazy person made that a denomination, but it's not. The Holy Ghost is just a part of the city. So no matter where we go, the Holy Ghost guides, keeps us, instructs us, empowers us. Y'all know what I'm talking about. And he gives us what we need to resist the enemy. Pastor, don't you talk like that? Now you about to make me feel at home? Yeah. Oh, the Holy Ghost. Listen. Look at somebody and tell them, say, I feel this thing. Say, excuse me while I praise him real quick. Go on and praise him. Go on. Come on, go on, praise him. Go on, praise him, y'all. Mess with you. Come on. Now, this is not an automatic. A lot of times people say this in churches to the pastor's wife, but this is real for you. Where is the book? It's two different things happening. I'm guilty too. I have not wrote mine. But I saw myself holding a book and a manual. This manual is practical. It's not a journal, but it's a manual, like a book club kind of manual. Am I talking to you? Okay. Because I thought it was me, because I ain't done it yet, and I know I'm supposed to do it. I haven't done it yet. But we're going to collab. You're going to write what God told you to write. I'm going to write mine. The only thing is you're going to encourage me to keep going. And I'm going to encourage you to finish. We're going to get us a date of expiration. Because look around this room. Every one of us need what you're getting ready to write. That simply means that some people, some things, some folks got to get off our schedule. And it's not to be mean, it's to get the manual out. Okay? Lift those hands. I want you to lift those hands. And just, not just about the book, but God told me to pray for you so that you can fully give yourself to this assignment. You don't want to be hurt. Because you don't just cry. You fight. I said it for you. And we know we don't want to be like that. We don't want to be like that. It's like I'm looking at myself. But woman of God, let me tell you something. This church needs more participation out of you. There's more work that will lighten the load for this man of God. Because the both of you have some great work to be done. In a small amount of time. It's not a time that I put on there, but it's a time that God has already spoken to you. You already know about it. She don't know because you told her some, but you didn't give her all. Because you know she don't really, she's like, I'll do that, but I don't do this. I feel you, girl. I do that all the time. And I find myself doing everything I say I don't want to do. Why? Because it is that personal time with God that puts me in that position. So when I steal away to pray, it is not to be separate from Him. It's to teach me how to be one with Him. Because a lot of first ladies are assuming they understand the oneness, and they do not. They assume it from a wedding marital kind of position, not a Trinity of God position. Father, Son, Holy Spirit is still one. He makes us one as we steal away with the Father so He can teach us how to be wives. Because we're not wives until He teaches us. Father, I thank you for this powerful woman of God. Give her a new surrender and a new will to do more for you. And even the women that know how to do it will submit themselves to your way of doing it. They're not going to move you out the way, say you don't know. They're just going to sit down because it's not their turn yet. It's for you to pour into them. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for it. In Jesus' name. Amen. We'll touch base with the book thing because I've been fighting it too, but we're going to get it out. Because everybody clap your hand. I got to let you go home. Give the greatest pastor in the world. Sir, could I do a You got your, you got your. Okay, I feel the leading to do it, but I don't go, I don't step my boundaries. Now, I don't do it, okay? But there are five, no, let me hear you, God, again. There are seven people, there are seven of you to sow a $100 seed. I'm one of them. So there are six of you. Harry, you're not going to fight with it. You're the ones that are not going to ponder with it. We're not going to fight about it. Come on, Harry. Two. Yes, Lord. Three. Four. Five. Shantae, look at my zipper. If it's more, it's okay. I'd rather you be more than none. But I heard the Lord. Harry, you got it? Okay, pastor, wife, hold mine. You hold mine. We together. We giving ours together. There you go. There are, and I heard this on the way here, y'all. I'm not guessing numbers. These are the things that God told me to do. The rest of you get a $20 seed in your hand, as close to it as you possibly can. Help even the children sow in this seed, in this ground. Come on. Harry. Is there anybody here that just don't have anything? Where are you? My integrity speaks for me. I never go places and tell people how much you have to give to me. I give them a range as to where it is and where their heart, because I want the heart of the leaders to know what my value is in coming in. And I pray that what I've delivered today was worth your seed that you have sown. My God. Sir, the thirst of God that's all over you. There's about four songs. There's a whole bunch of them, but there are four of them that you need to hurry up and get them out. God is giving you the names of the people, the voices behind it, but there are songs you have that need to get out. I don't know. Maybe you can sing them all. It's up to you, but you know what I'm saying? Get them out. All I know, he said, tell him to get it out. Because when you get it out, you're in the birth canal. You're there, ready to push forward. Because you want God like never before. You've never wanted him as bad as you want him right now. You want him. Yeah. Lord, I ain't going to have no other service, but I keep seeing things. Lord, I thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the healing of your people. Get that $20 seed in your hand. Hurry up. You got your phones lifted up to me? Yeah. There you go. All the technology. Look at y'all. Don't y'all play with me, though. Push that button. Don't be saying I got it right here. Push the button to the church. Father, I thank you for the seed that is about to be sown in this house. As a woman of God, God, I ask you to open up the windows of heaven for this body of believers and give them blessings that they don't have room to receive. Release it to them in the name of Jesus. Let them experience your glory like never before. Let a harvest overtake them. And lastly, God, I pray that you will save their families. Save them, deliver them, free them from the pit of sin. Bring them to know you like never before. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Put a praise with that seed that you have in your hand. Come on, put a praise with that. And go ahead and sow your seed with, what, a deacon. Somebody right here on both sides. If you have the money in your hand, release it in one of the men of God, Trinity. Now let's receive the greatest pastor in the world, Trinity Harvest. Come on. Am I saying it right? Trinity Harvest. Come on, receive our pastor, our bishop. Love you, man.
Hallelujah. Come on and give the Lord a hand praise for Evangelist Thompson. Amen, amen. She doesn't know it, but the Lord had already put it on my heart that this consecration seed is a seed that this church family is going to sow into her. Amen. The honorarium was already taken care of, but this seed today will be sown into her. Give God a hand praise again. Let me just tell you, she, as she shared with you, is a wife of 38 years, a mother of four, and a grandmother of six. So that means on this Mother's Day, she's away from her family on assignment to deliver what God had for us today. And so if I can just put two more dollars in her gas tank to help her to get back home, amen, to her family, we thank God that we're able to do that. Listen, all of our first-time guests, again, I know we've been a long, long while here today, but look at what the Lord has done. Yeah, yeah. The thing that I whispered in Evangelist Thomas's ear was, in her words, she said that we need to have a protected birthing place. And that's one of the largest things that spoke out in the word today was Trinity Harvest is a protected birthing place. And so everything that you've been afraid to do, everything you've been afraid to walk into, this is a place and a space that is protected by the anointed power of the Holy Ghost. And we are about to see some supernatural changes, some supernatural manifestations in the life of the people of this church. Now, I'll start another service if you praise the Lord. Amen. And I'm claiming that for my own life. I love every last one of you. And I stand guard at the door against the Egyptian. I wish an Egyptian would walk up in here and try to kill what the Lord is about to do. The devil is a lie. I'm sorry. I'm just saying. I'm ready. Are you ready? Hallelujah. Amen. Come on and stand. I'm going to give us a closing prayer. Father, we bless you. We thank you today for what our eyes have seen, for what our ears have heard. We thank you for the deliverance. We thank you for the release. We thank you for the instructions, the wisdom, and the revelation today. We thank you, God, for the powerful woman of God who you have brought into this place today, God, to crack the seal on what you're doing in our lives. And so we bless you. Give it back to her, God. 30-fold. Give it back, God. 60-fold. Pour it in. 100-fold, God. Times over, exponentially beyond what she sold out and poured out today. So we thank you for these people. We thank you for your spirit. We thank you and we bless you in Jesus' mighty name. Come on and give the Lord a shout of praise as you are being dismissed. Hallelujah. Go with God and have a blessed week. One, two, one.
Thank you for joining us. We pray that you are blessed, and this is just the beginning of an amazing week for you. If you're ever in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, we'd love for you to stop by. As always, you can connect with us anywhere in the world at tacconnects.com or on social media. Enjoy the rest of your day, and we will see you next week.